Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nidjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here is part 2 of St. Peter's ecclesiastical word, which is for the first community of children. Thus, St. Peter became the apostle in planting churches, warning the congregations to stick to the Ten Commandments of Moses if they want to receive gospel in their hearts. Remember, Jesus told his laborers, do what the rabbis tell you to do, but don't follow their examples. That is, Christ Jesus fulfilled the moral laws of Moses in Saint Peter, who received the keys to the kingdom of heaven that used to be with the rabbis. And this kingdom of heaven is on the earth and not up in the sky, where soul will rest after death. Kingdom of heaven is related to flesh. And when you have law and order in society, then you say it is heaven. And when there is a disturbance, killing, robbing, etc., then you say it's hell. So, kingdom of heaven is for the flesh, and peace of mind, or the royal kingdom of God that is within our hearts, is for our souls. For this reason, St. Peter became disabled, that the people who were keen to establish a church would make efforts to carry him to their towns. That is, in Christ Jesus, we do not throw pearls before swine. The first church in Jerusalem presented an ideal congregation when people were sons of Abraham and had tribal conscience, truthfulness, contentment, and mercy. Brother Stephen was a wise man of Holy Ghost, and he groomed the congregation for apostles to sow the seed of his word. Then St. James the Just was also the same, but soon after the deaths of these two, the next bishops were timid, and they gave in to the pressure of the hostile Jews, bringing in the Jewish demon of reading the scriptures without understanding in spirit, that Christ Jesus had warned that do not bring in the leaven of the Jewish people. Bishops became greedy and immoral, and the apostles used to rebuke them for their immoral practices. The bishop retorted to the rebukes of apostles by banning them from their churches, and they appointed presbyters to read the dead letters of the written Torah, as the Jews used to read, and of the New Testament as well. Apostles opened monasteries, and the rest I have explained in other videos. Dead people of letters, like Origen, who could not understand that a Jew is inwardly and not outwardly, became their authorities on scriptures, or they called them church fathers. In Nicene Creed, they proclaimed Christ was born, died, and rose on third day, when Christ stands for Word of God, that became flesh in the name of Jesus. So it was Jesus who was born, died, and rose on third day, not the Christ. This reflected the darkness they had created in churches. Saint Peter was made to sit by the Christ Jesus in the seat of Prophet Elijah that used to be with John the Baptist, who died fighting the sinners. Remember that John the Baptist was Prophet Elijah, and after his death, St. Peter took over his duties. In St. Peter, the sinners were killed, and keeping of the Ten Commandments was a must. Remember, John the Baptist told the soldiers not to take any bribe or to tell lies. So same as the Ten Commandments. Saul was also once born, but he was made drunk with the old wine of scriptures, and Christ Jesus had mercy upon him and blessed him with the very Spirit of God, like the other 12 at Pentecost. St. Paul also worked in collaboration with St. Peter, advising the congregations about the moral behavior expected in an ideal church of God, but he did not have the keys to the kingdom of heaven, as St. Peter was. St. Paul, like the other apostles, concentrated upon the exposition of his word with mastery over the written Torah. St. Peter used to put on dark colored, colorful clothes, as children do like, eat to his heart's content and sleep carefully. Remember that these bishops and popes, they put on these colorful robes. They are copies of the dress that Peter liked, colorful dresses. He loved Christ Jesus very much, but when Christ Jesus was beaten mercilessly by the Roman soldiers who were bribed by the temple priests, then like a child frightened of corporal punishment, he denied Christ Jesus. As children are the once born are forgivable, so he was forgiven for denying Christ Jesus. That is why he was the first to rush to the empty tomb to show the love for Jesus. Walking on the water is symbolic of the twice born in Christ Jesus, to be greater than the once born in John the Baptist, that he started to sink when he wanted to go for Christ Jesus, because St. Peter was once born, not twice born. So he did not have the same knowledge as the other apostles or the workers had. Remember that the least of the workers of Christ Jesus is greater than John the Baptist. So all the church bishops were supposed to be in the image of St. Peter or John the Baptist. They should instruct their congregation to be obeying the Ten Commandments of Moses or to be morally sound, so that the apostles could sow the seed of his word in their hearts. That is why St. Peter was the rock over which Church of God would be built. That means liars, cheats and hypocrites have no place in the Church of God. But today you see that the churches are full of these people, and they are so ignorant of St. Peter that instead of having the spiritual rock, they build the churches devoted to St. Peter of stones, of the rocks. And that way they think, oh, the house is built on the rock. But today's it is the opposite. Hypocrite politicians, the psychics, are given chances to address the congregations while the gospel truth preachers are out of their churches. So anybody who speaks gospel truth is thrown out of the church, as I am sometime not welcomed in churches. So wake up to the standard of St. Peter if you want to love his word, the bitter pill of gospel. Psychic politicians have, oh dear.